Curious Droid presents 5 supersized drones you can ride in. Over the past few years, some people have taken drones from small, almost toy devices for carrying cameras and the like to mini aircraft that are capable of carrying a single person or more. And now these supersized drones are touted as a possible future for personal transportation for both civilians and military personnel. These are still very early days. Years of testing will lie ahead before these are allowed to fly in public areas, so don't expect to see anything like this soon. But here we look at 5 of the drones you can ride in. The EHang 184 created a huge buzz when it was debuted at the CES 2016 show. They claim it's the world's first fully autonomous helicopter drone. The EHang 184 is a 200kg 8-rotor aircraft, which the company claims is able to lift a single 100kg person up to 500 meters into the air and fly them at up to 100km an hour to any point on Google Maps, all whilst avoiding objects automatically and safely handling the takeoff and landing without the need of any piloting skills from the person being carried. The range is as far as it can fly, with 23 minutes of flight time afforded by the batteries, which have a recharge time of around 2 hours. EHang is keen to point out that in the event of a drone experiencing problems, human pilots housed in custom-built command centers will be able to take over and guide you to safety. Hopefully there will also be a parachute should you have a complete power loss at 500 meters up. Price should be around about $180,000 to $260,000 each. In the Netherlands, Torsten Cranes, the man behind QUADRO UAS, has been developing an autonomous aircraft and has been featured on the news and TV programs around Europe. QUADRO UAS is primarily a one-man operation, and Torsten started out as a software engineer and gained experience whilst working at a company making unmanned aerial systems. However, he soon realized that he needed more experience in other technical areas, like mechanical stress calculations and circuit design. He has spent a lot of time gaining these new skills and also cooperating with other people in order to make his prototype aircraft. Torsten's design has 20 electrically powered motors, each driving one propeller, and is stabilized by a multi-wee autopilot control system. Torsten is also in talks with the Dutch Aviation Authority in order to get a flight certificate, and hopes that in the future you will be able to order your personal aircraft by smartphone and it will land wherever you are before taking you onto your destination. The AERO-X from Los Angeles firm AERO-X Incorporated is a two-man low-altitude flying vehicle that's sort of a drone, but it isn't a drone, and it's also a sort of flying all-terrain vehicle. One of the major differences between the AERO-X and other electrically powered type drone craft is that it's much simpler and uses no electronic stabilization control systems. It is designed to be ridden much like a motorbike, but also can be used as an unmanned vehicle to do agricultural duties like crop spraying and surveying, for example. It uses 2 inline ducted fans powered by petrol engines. The design of the ducts around the edges of the fans give it the stability and the control. The idea behind the AERO-X is not a new one though, and it's actually based on a design from over 50 years ago. The PA-59K flying jeep or air jeep was created by Frank N. Pasecki, founder of Pasecki Helicopter and Aircraft Corporation. The air jeep was the winner of a US Army competition to make a low flying vehicle capable of traveling over land or water, a bit like a hovercraft, but whilst being able to fly over trees and larger obstacles. It also had a top speed of up to 75 miles an hour. Although the air jeep was field tested, the Army chose to stick with the helicopters, and the idea was dropped until AERO-X took it up again. Because the craft is designed to travel at only around about 10 feet above the ground and is controlled like a bike, the rider does not require any private pilot's license. Shipping is scheduled to start in 2017 with a price tag of $85,000 each. The FLIKE, or flying bike, is an electrically powered tricopter designed by the Hungarian Bayzoltan Limited. The idea of a FLIKE was originally conceived in the summer of 2014, when a magazine article appeared that said that drones were okay as small craft, but would not be able to carry the weight of a person. This gave the design team the idea to make a drone that could carry a person, and in the space of a year, they took the idea from the drawing board to their first manned flight. The 6-motor design is in a Y formation, with the rotors on top of each other in a similar design to the EHang 184. Bay-Zoltan are claiming that the Flike will be able to travel at an electronically limited height of 30 metres at up to 100 kilometres per hour. Carrying capacity of the Flike is up to 100 kilograms, and the flight time is up to 60 minutes with the extended range version. Because the Flike is fully stabilised and controlled by a computer, the rider will require few piloting skills, though you may still require a pilot's licence like you do for a small plane or microlight. The flight control will be by joystick, and because it's fully computer controlled, it will also be capable of unmanned autonomous flight. Availability is said to be sometime in 2016, and the price is yet to be announced, but they said it will be in the sports car bracket. Hopefully that's the Mazda MX-5 price bracket and not that of a Ferrari 458. The German-made Volocopter blurs the lines between a drone and a helicopter and is aimed at those who want the flying experience of the helicopter but without the high costs and long training times involved. The layout of the Volocopter is similar to the helicopter, with the rotors in a fixed grid above the main cabin and a similar size to the swept area of a normal helicopter rotor. The difference between the helicopter and a Volocopter is that the Volocopter has 18 electrically powered rotors, and this means that there is much more built-in redundancy, so you could lose a couple of rotors, for example, and still be able to fly. Being electric, it's also emissions free, and it also requires much less maintenance than a traditional helicopter. Rather than being fully autonomous like the EHang, Volocopter wanted to give the pilot the fun of flying, but with all the advantages that a fully computerized system could give. This would allow them to fly with just the joystick, just like a computer game, but also be able to switch to fully automatic if required. The computers take care of the actual flying, the takeoff and landing, and can even compensate for turbulence. All the pilot needs to do is just point it where he needs to actually go. Plan is to have a single-seater fun model and then a 2- and 4-seater models for commercial and private transport. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, then don't forget to please thumbs up and subscribe for more. And if you have any ideas for videos you'd like to see, then please let us know in the comments below.